wanted to say grace, what's the meaning of grace? It's like the beginning of understanding that God chose you. That's the beginning. The moment you get that understanding that God chose you, you are on the side of God, despise whatever. It means everything will work for you. That beginning of understanding that God chose you and chose you that you must not operate like others. There are benefits. Tell anybody there are benefits. Yes. The moment you understand that God chose you, you need to learn. You need to learn the principles of working with God. Our challenge is, many times we don't know God chose us. We end up operating like heathen. People who don't know God. So when we talk about the grace, is the understanding that God gives you to know that God chose you. It's not an issue of say, I have the grace. No. You can say it if you are operating on His principles. You can say that you have the grace. Because once you have the grace, and you say you have the grace, and you're operating in His principles, whether life is tough or not, you know what will happen. You just find out in His will, which is the Word of God, the Bible, that, okay, what are my benefits if God chose me? What is it that is required of me? Christians need to know that. The moment you know that, you are blessed. Because maybe you're not getting a job. You just know that, oh, God chose me. There's a system that God has established. And that system, God want me to be aligned with it. I don't know if you're hearing me. Tell somebody, my friend, God chose you. When God chooses people, listen, He doesn't look at your background. He doesn't look at what? Your background or what people knows about you. That's why we talk about grace. You know, our challenges today is we don't know the issue of Jesus is my friend. Jesus is my savior. Jesus, automatically I will spend time talking with Him. We need to sense the issue of my relationship with Jesus. Knowing why He chose me is to have principles established that I will follow. Like now, you know what's the meaning of principle? It's something that cannot be broken. It's established. Okay, God say, you sit here. Eh? And somebody say, why are you sitting there? You say, no. Though it looks stupid, but I will sit. This is a principle that God has established. I must sit here. But do you know why the grace is not functioning for us? Because we don't know that God gives us grace, number one. Two, principles that must be followed are ignored. It's as good as you are driving a car, but there's a freeway. Are you hearing me? And then you are just looking on other signs to follow. The road that we are moving on is just a freeway, but we are looking for other signs that we know, and they are not on freeway. Okay, there's no stop sign on freeway, but we stop. What will happen? We danger ourselves and others. So we are trying to look other things, you know, but here we are on freeway. It's a straight road. You just accelerate. So our relationship with Jesus will be established because we know that we have been given grace. Therefore, there are things that I won't do because it affects the grace that God gave me. Okay, there are things that I won't believe which are wrong, it will happen to me. Because what? I have the grace. You know, one time I said, when we were starting here, I said, I have the grace, you can't stop me. Because I know the grace, once you have it, it's a freeway. It's a what? So you just accelerate and accelerate, accelerate and accelerate. And today, you accelerate into your destiny. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, say, I'm accelerating to my destiny. When something wrong happened to you, remember, you can't stop. Because there's no stop sign on freeway. You can't look back because you've got responsibility here. You accelerate. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Amen.
And you know the one who put you there. Listen to this. The challenge of the grace is when there are negative things that devil brings so that you look on. That's the challenge of the grace. Negative things that steals your focus so that you forget that you have the grace. The grace that God gave us teaches us that no. We just say, no, this one. It's not the sign. I'm accelerating. No, this one. It's not my life.
It's
just say, no, I'm not a failure. No, Jesus is my Lord. If we have that, even if there's poverty, disease, lack, they will listen to us. I don't know if you're hearing me. There are some things that are waiting, are checking you, are looking on you. They are questioning you if you are aware of the grace you've been given. Like now, when you are sick, you know the grace. By His stripes you are healed.
Eh? Amen.
Okay, you know when you are poor, you know the Bible says you are blessed. So those things will come. Those funny things will come to test if really you know the grace that you have been given. So that grace, you won't look on those things if you are aware of the grace. You will look at the principles. Because the principles guide you to where God is taking you. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Amen.
I just want to say to you, congratulations, that you are going to your destiny. How many of you knows that? How many of you? I know you are going to your destiny. I want to say congratulations. I say you are blessed in Jesus' name. Shake someone and say, hey, I'm not a failure. Don't judge me by my experiences. My relationship with Jesus cannot be affected with anything because I know I have the grace. I know I have the grace. Say it, I know I have the grace.
I know I have the grace.
Congratulations, congratulations. Amen. I was told to tell you that. Let's open the Bibles. This is what I want to teach you. If you read Galatians 4,
Galatians 4,
verse 1 and 2.
Verse 1 and 2.
But I say that so long as the heir is a child, he differeth nothing from a bond servant, though he's a lord of all. But he's under guidance and stewards until the day appointed of the Father.
Amen.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to talk about appointed time. I was reading this, I found that truly everybody is having the time that God has set for you. The Bible says a child of a rich man cannot control the riches as long as he's a child. I think that's the clear meaning of the scripture. Until appointed time, when the child is matured, If it's just a child, they are guidance and stewards.
Wana le batho ba mmolla lebeletseng ba mogodishao le ba mofang maele.
You know, stewards,
le bona ba fang motho maele ba ba motlatang,
are there for direction.
Ba gona hore ba tla ba o fetsopa tsela.
They are there for direction.
Ba gona o fetsopa tsela.
It means you can be a hare.
Wana re wena o ka ba mojalefa.
Without direction.
Mara o sna tsopa
tsela. You are not a hare.
Wana re ona awona asi wena mojalefa.
Because a hare is a person who have got a promise.
Ka bana mojalefa ke motho yana le tshepiso.
And that promise will be fulfilled by the appointed time.
Ana tshepiso ye tata ipetsala ka le bakale itseng.
Can you see when this somebody say I'll buy you a suit man.
Le bana motho mngare tsa selengwe ke to rekela suit.
You see a suit.
Wa ibona suit.
You dream it.
Wa ilora.
But you want that time to come.
Maro nya gore nako ye life ite.
So this is the time
that you
have been waiting
for.
It is your appointed
time.
Listen.
I
have read in Ecclesians
3
verse 1.
Verse 1.
It says, in every season. In fact, it says, in everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose. When I was reading this, I realized that the purpose in life is having a season that has been set. But there's a time where the purpose will be clear to everybody.
It's
when the time of that season comes. Let me try to say the time in the season.
Nako kara mohla go ba kara le bakale.
Example.
Ke le feng motlhala.
You can harvest is a time of harvesting.
O ka bona ke nako ya u bona ke le bakala gona.
In that season of harvest.
Kara le bakalona le ula u bona.
There's a time of eating the harvest.
Ona le nako ya u ja tse u di boneng.
I'm sure you understand that.
Ke a dumela lang kwishisha.
So in everything.
Jana go dilo tse ka moka ona le mohla wa dilo.
And a time.
Ke le bele ona le baka.
Sometimes
na go chetingwe
sometimes people
na go chetingwe batho
are experiencing seasons
ba kopana le mohla o ba le mabaka
but they can't have the time
mara na go ya ona dilo tse we abanayo
there's a season
ona le le batho e bele ona le nako
I don't know if you hear me
a ke tsiba lento
there's a season of harvest
ona le le baka la u bona
and the time you know
na nako ye wena o itse
that you have harvested
ya uri u bunne
hallelujah
amen.
If you read that, you realize that.
Awo bala botsimotlo le more.
In the purpose of life.
Mo la morero wa bophelo.
Where you write something about your life.
Mo wena o gona ngo rata o rengwala sesimo ka bophelo.
Because about purpose is when you live a life in fullness.
Ke o thomo phila bophelo ba o khotsofatsa.
Where you are writing something that somebody will learn.
Mo gona ngo ngwala ntwe engwe motho tatanga ithuta yona.
On that time.
Ka nako yona yeo.
You must know that.
O tsebege hore
everything becomes beautiful if it's appointed.
Dilo ka ofela di batse di botse if di beilwe kana go ya tsona.
I want to tell you that you have been waiting for the time.
Khale sela le mechina go.
This is the time.
And ye ke yona nako ya gona.
You know, if you read John 7.
Le bona le ka ya bokeng ya John 7.
You read from verse 1.
La iba lo tlo go verse 1.
You can be shocked Jesus disciples were with him.
O tla makala ba rutwa ba Jesus ne bana le yena. Le bo buthe ba ga e batla.
And they came to say, you see, it is your time to show off.
Ne batla bo bolelo re ke nako ya ga hore o bona ga lo ba o bontshe.
You can't just do these things in the corner.
O ka se no dia dilo tse o fita etse.
And the Bible says,
Bible for 3 years.
Jesus says,
Jesu are.
You all have times.
Ya but ka mo go ba tshe ga mo ka tshe na le nako.
Because he knew his time.
Ka ba natse ba nako ya gagwe.
If you read on top the Bible says,
A ba la mola go dimo ya thoma
ire. They wanted to kill him.
Bible re ne ba nya ko mmolaya.
The people wanted to kill him but the brothers were advising for him to be killed.
But ban ne ba nyako mola ma bo botine ba mona ya ma
hele o bona.
O ka re na ko ya ta ba yang ke.
He's going to show off to the people.
Yo boncha batho.
If he might have done that.
Anka ba ya dirile nto ya o boncha.
The Pharisees were supposed to have stoned him.
Ba Pharisee ne ba tla ba mothumile ka maswika.
Can I tell you this?
Re ke le botseng.
Sometimes we are guided by the people.
Na ku tshedingwe re tlhatwa ke batho.
But it looks so fine.
Mara o bona ala o ka re ka mokadi lokile.
And we meet problems.
Ra tara kopana le mathata. kopile.
This brother say, you see what?
Ba ha ba re bolela ba re wa bona king.
It's your time now.
Ke nako ya ga wana jwa
tshe. Show off.
Ya o bontshe.
Can you just show off?
O ka no bontsha na.
Then do these things when you are hiding.
O fetisha go di tlo i pitlela ra owa.
I know my time.
Ke tsiba nako ya ka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We need to know our times.
Re to kotse ba dinako tsha rena.
The right time comes.
Hana ko ya gona e fita.
There is no danger.
A ona ko tse.
When the right time comes.
Botsa mtle ka hana ko ya gona e fita.
There is no danger.
A ona ko tse.
You see, I've seen this thing by us who are called.
Le ya bona ke bone ntwe e ka rena ba re be di tshweu.
The reason why many of us are attacked.
Le ba ka la hore ba bontshi ba rena re attackiwe.
We don't wait for the time.
A re emele nako.
The time appointed.
Nako e be ilweng.
If you read in Acts.
A o bala mola ditiro.
If you just read there, you find the Acts 1.
Mola wo ditiro chapter 1.
Jesus was saying, wait for me.
Jesore akeng le le ntite le nkemele.
Holy Spirit will come.
Moyo mogetho o tla.
And the time came.
Ene nako ya gona ya fitla.
When the time came, everybody knew.
Ana ko e fitla motho ka moka
tsebe. Listen, when the time comes, everybody will know.
Ana ko e fitla motho ka o fela o tlo tsebe.
Shake somebody, everybody will know.
Motho ka moka o tlo tsebe.
If now you just do things
I don't know when automodia dilona ko yona iso fitle
you'll find that you are just endangering yourself
o tatholoro itokela ka radikotsi
endangering other people
ebe lodia maphilo abangwe batho ba bangwe ba be dikotseng.
God is setting this time
modimo ul beila baya nakoye
that this time
ore nakoye li yona ye
the power of God will manifest
ayo godimo atla bona
ga people will know you
ene batho batlo motsiba
nobody will be able to hide you
motho atla gona ngo mofe
it is your time to be known
ina ko ya lena ya o tsibiwa
so my friend it is your time
ina ko ya gao
to be known
ya re wena o tsibe
everybody must know you are around
fela zo juno tsibo routine
shake sabe say hey
khwata motho lo khafriela
does they know you are around
ba tsiba na o routine
think about people who are expecting bad things about you.
Na na batho ba ona ganela nto tse di mpe ba di lebeletse.
And they are surprised you are not facing that.
Ene ba makala o sa kopane le tsona.
Because when God bring that appointed time.
Ka ba ne modimo a fitisa semo sona se sa se beileng.
Your friends will know.
Ba mogotsi ya ba tatse ba.
Your neighbors will know.
Bo makhiba tsebe.
Everybody will know.
Motho ka ofela a tsebe.
That your time that has been appointed.
Re wena na go yela e beilweng.
To rise up has come.
Ya go phaga me fitile.
I say it is your time.
Ke nako ya le.
I say it is your time. I say it is your time. If you believe shout
hallelujah.
Look at this temptations that has happened.
Are level me ditiko tse
di tele.
Luka 22.
28:29. 28:29. Whoever is appointed in the kingdom must
yena
yo abe ilwe
mom mushong o tsojono kopana le miliko
Luke 22
Luke 22
are you there
litotse
from 28
oto verse 28
let me read there
erekele maleng yona
he says what he says but ye are they that have continued with me in my temptation
ke lena ba le goteletseng melikong le nna
can you see that verse there
le bona verse eo
and 20:29 and I appoint unto you a kingdom even as my father appointed unto me
ya nong ke le ke kgetha mo mushong jwa le ka e papa nna a mpeile mushu.
This is a lesson to all of us.
Ye ki thuto re na ka moka.
Jesus said you have continued with
me. Ori Jesu li lela tswana pele le etong le nna.
In my temptation.
Ka ra ditiko tsaka.
Now I appoint you. Tsano
nge ki kgetha lena he.
As the Father has appointed.
Tsela ka re nna papa kgethile tele tsa.
Temptations.
Meliko e
shows that you are appointed.
E bontsho re wena o kgethilwe.
And being appointed.
Ene tsano nga o kgethilwe.
You don't need to worry about the temptations.
A o bolela ka meliko ye.
You are appointed for something.
Wena o kgethile o kgethelwa ntwe e tshe.
But there will be a time.
Mara jo nang o tlo ba le lebaka le nako.
People will know.
Ye batho ba tla thoma go
tsiba.
Lo tlhaloganya. Ore why wena o ile wa kgethwa.
So when you judge people by their temptations.
Wena o tlo mo a meliko ya bona o di tshona.
Can I tell you again?
Ere ke bo she.
When you judge people.
A o tlo mo a thula batho.
By their temptations.
Ka meliko ya bona.
You are very wrong.
Wena o di tshona o
phoso. Jesus said.
Jesu a re.
I'm appointing you.
Nna ke kgetha bo lena.
You saw what I went through.
Le bone hore ke kopane le.
You continue with me.
La tswela pele le lena le nna.
In other words Jesus was saying.
Ka mantswe mangwe Jesu na bolela hore.
The temptations that I went through.
Meliko nna ke kopaneng le yona.
Were also tempting you.
Le lena ne ile leka.
We're tempting you
nelilika
so that you must turn back
or lewele ko lichwang
can you see why temptations are around us is to make us to turn back from Jesus. So Jesus will appoint us as the Father appointed
him.
Listen, I've read the scriptures. It talks about fivefold ministries. Where the Bible says God himself chooses. God himself decides. But here, Jesus is saying, I'm the one who's appointing you. After temptations, I appoint you. I don't know if you're hearing me. I believe today the time of that appointment, of the fulfillment of that appointment, it has come. This is the time of your blessing. This is the time of reaching a higher level. This is the time that those who think you are small, they worship your God. This is the time that those who have rejected you will come closer to you. This is the time you've been waiting for. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ask your neighbor, say, hey, what is it that you are waiting for? So what you are waiting for, it's a season of it. But the time of getting, it's now. It's not tomorrow. It's not tomorrow, is when. It's a season. When you see somebody giving a testimony, say, I'm blessed. Just know that my time has come. When you hear somebody say, I'm healed and you are sick, just know that your time has come. Never look at your circumstances or your challenges. God is God of everything. He can bless you and raise you and lift you and take you to a higher level. It is your time. Tell him, it's my time. Say, it is my time. Can you tell somebody, say, it's my time to rise up and walk? It is my time for my career. It is my time. It is your time for what? Say. Do you know that when God's time comes, it comes with expectations. I want to tell you this. Listen very carefully. Even people around, they sense it. There's something coming. Others take it on the other side. Steal it. It's as good as when you see your time to get a job. The moment you receive a call, you find another one is coming. You find another. And you find others, they sense that it is your time. They can't wait, they search for you. When your time has come, no struggle. The Bible says, when the appointed time of Jesus to be born comes,
he was born.
And everybody was waiting for Messiah when Jesus was born. But there were many, many children. Many, many children were born. Even some people, you know, by the time of, you know, Jesus, when they hear that the Messiah will be born, others start to fall in love. They wanted to give birth to Messiah. If you read about Jesus, how he was born, you realize this thing was happening. Because the Bible says, Joseph was not yet married. They were not yet married. Mary was not yet married to Joseph.
Mariana so nyalane le Joseph.
They were still engaging. Even the engagement was not even like engagement. People were were promising each other.
Hey, you know what?
They say Messiah will be born.
Expectation
was too much. Too much pregnancies.
And
the children were born. They were too much. And you know, the angel came to Mary and said,
Maria,
the time appointed has come. You'll be pregnant. And the child will come. And when that time comes, the Bible says, the hotels were full. The question was, what about hospitals? Were full. The hospital were full. Everybody was pregnant. This one is Messiah.
This one is Messiah.
You know, until these people, they would go to the place where they are not supposed to go there. They go to the stable. And Messiah was born there because the hospitals were full. Expectation was too much. And the Bible says, when it has happened, when Herod started to hear that this child is born, he just said, no, 2 years. He counted and said, 2 years. I heard this thing from 2 years. That Messiah will be born. Can we start from a baby of 2 years to the one of 1 day? Let's destroy all. Let's destroy this. And God was already saving the Messiah. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, before you give a testimony, you'll just hear somebody giving a testimony. Don't be afraid. Don't be shaken. I don't know if you're hearing me. Don't be shaken by somebody's testimony. We just say, oh, hey, God has blessed me with a car. Hey, God has blessed me with a heart. Don't be shaken. Those are false things. The right time you're about to give birth to you. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shake somebody and say, hey, my time has come. Did you read about
Solomon?
Before Solomon became a king,
Solomon asobi khoshi.
Oh, there was a man there called. There was
Adonijah.
There was Absalom. They did many things. They wanted to be kings. Until the prophet came and said,
prophet,
to all this nonsense that has been done here, there is
Solomon.
You said you will be a king. And it happened. When you see too much activities, it must not bother you. There's a time that God has appointed. And this time will never pass. And this time is today. And if you believe, shout
hallelujah.
So, you look around, you see people enjoying their lives, you are afraid. You look at your schoolmates, you remember, oh, you were better than them. You look around, you find some people who were dunderheads. Now they are just moving, they are living a better life. You look around, you compete yourself with others. I'm here to tell you, you are about to overtake them. Say, I'm about to overtake you. I will overtake you. It is my time. So, unless the time comes, the wrong people will be negative. Are you hearing me? If the right time for right people to raise, to be raised by God, if it does not come, wrong people will be rich. They will take money. Wrong people will just do whatever they are doing. God must raise you. God must raise you now. Your time has come. I say, your time has come. It is your time. Say, it is my time. Say, it is my time. It is my time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Congratulations.